in an equations tournament, there are matches, or you might call them rounds. Typically, in a competition that we attend, there are two matches, each lasting about 30 minutes. A round consists of multiple shakes, at least one. Sometimes a game goes so long that only one occurs. A shake is considered when you roll the dice, all the cubes, and the play of the game continues until one player, at least, correctly answers and using the cubes on the playing mat. The following equipment is needed: 24 cubes, 6 of each color, red, blue, green, and black. These cubes will either have a digit or an operation sign on them. A playing mat with sections for goal, required, permitted, and forbidden. There are sometimes a section for resources, but is not necessary. A 1 minute stand timer to keep track of time, and a challenger block. The challenge block must be a cube or similar object and not a flat coin, a flat object like a coin. It could also needs to be small enough that only one player can grab at a time. We don't want it so large that two players grab it simultaneously. Players are allowed to use paper that's blank, pencils or pens, but they can't bring anything like prepared notes, can't bring any books, tables like multiplication tables, calculators, cell phones, or any other electronic devices. Those have to be left at home. The goal setter for the first shake is determined by rolling the red cube. So each of those two or three players, will roll a red cube. Whoever has the highest will be the first goal setter. If you happen to roll an operation sign, you're eliminated unless all two or three players that are participating all roll operation signs. Otherwise, it eliminates you. The person who has the highest will go. If it happens to be a tie for the highest, then you'll roll again until that tie is broken. From that point on, as each shake ends, the next person to be the goal setter will be the person to the left of the first goal setter. So the play will continue clockwise.